Okay, Alan, thanks for joining us. Hope you had a great Christmas. And let's go back briefly and talk about the Ayr game last weekend. They were the league leaders at the time. We all knew it was going to be a difficult match. It was a performance of two halves, though, wasn't it?
First half, we never done enough. I don't think there was many opportunities. Probably Ayr had the best opportunity. We had a similar opportunity at the other end with Aidan Keane as well. But it wasn't a great game. First half, I thought it was a wee bit scrappy. Second half, I thought we were much better. We were probably the better team and had opportunities again, but we never managed to get the goal.
We knew how dangerous they would be up front. Shankland had, you know, his chance at the end, but apart from that, you know, pretty anonymous in terms of what else he gave to the game. And that must be pleasing. That's another clean sheet.
It's another clean sheet, but probably with the way it was going, you're thinking we don't take our chances. They get a chance last minute, you're expecting it to win. So maybe that's a turn, a fortune that we need, and hopefully now we can kick on.
I mentioned the clean sheets, but obviously it's three games without scoring a goal at the other end. You'd prefer a better balance, wouldn't you?
No, you can see where the problems have lied since the start of the season, to be honest with you. We've not scored enough goals as a team. Obviously the large part of the responsibility goes to strikers. They need to stand up and go and score the goals that we need. But for that to happen, the supply's got to be better, the crossing's got to be better. And other people have got to chip in as well.
Are you, is there a striker on your radar in the next week or so?
There's people we're looking at, but whether we can get them in or not, we'll just have to wait and see. It just depends on the availability as well, so time will tell.
Are you expecting any more movement in or out?
It's hard to tell. Now, obviously, January's a long month, so we'll wait and see what happens. But I think it'd be good to strengthen, and obviously it'd be good to bring in somebody that's a goal threat.
Falkirk on Saturday then, big game for the fans, big game for everyone, for both sides of supporters actually, and given where we are in the league and where they are, it's vital that we get all 3 points.
Yeah, no, it's every game's vital now. If we want to start closing the gap, and we've said it for a number of weeks, we need to start winning, putting a run together, but the next couple of weeks coming up is against teams obviously below us, so it's vitally important we get the 3 points.
And we want to avoid a situation. Last time we played Falkirk here at East End, they suckered us a bit. We could have been probably 3-4 goals up, and then they grabbed the goal in the second half. That's something to be avoided, obviously.
It is, but they're a hard team to beat. If you look at their record recently, they're defending well. They've picked up a few results. They get numbers behind the ball and make it really difficult to defend and look to try and break on you. So that's the way they're playing. So obviously we've got to make sure we don't get caught in the counter-attack.
And finally, it's not been the best time for injuries. What's the latest on the casualties?
Andy Ryan, he's these operations, so he's going to be out for a few months. Aidan Connolly, he's just coming back for injury, so hopefully he's going to join in full training next week if all goes to plan. Louis Longridge has just picked up a little niggle on his way back for injury, so he's probably going to be a wee bit longer than we expected. And Sean Murdoch's still injured.